think it's more mental than anything. Sometimes you just don't feel like coming to the rink, especially when things aren't going well. Do you want to get rocked? You know, it's your job. I help them do it.
Being a professional hockey player is no easy task, and when you play for the Fort Worth Brahmas of the Western Professional Hockey League, you don't live a cushy life. Players have to pack their own bags, and rookies are expected to bring all the other equipment on board for away games.
That's all hockey, you know, you unpack your stuff, and it takes 2 seconds, you just get used to it. We're not in the big league, so.
There are 16 teams in the league, and you mostly travel by bus. You play a grueling 70-game schedule, and playing 3 games in 3 nights with 12-hour road trips in between is not uncommon.
Now we're playing a lot of Friday, Saturday, Sunday games, and after a Friday, Saturday, Sunday game, you're beat up, you're worn down, and it takes a toll on your body physically.
Matrix.
Food money is scarce. The average per diem is only $24 a day.
Buy what you have to buy, you know, it's usually juicing a power bar, keeps you going, you know. It's a road trip. Most of the guys already ate. Now it's just to get a little something right before the game, keep it going. Then we'll have like pizzas or something afterwards on their way home.
Superstitious, I guess. Before every game, I always have a strawberry milk. One time I had it, and I think I scored or something ridiculous like that. So now I always seem to get one of those. Mountain Dew, I'm addicted to. I can't help it.
In this league, new players come and go all the time.
Come and see me in about 15 minutes at the front of the bus, and we'll get you signed.
Martin Williams just flew in from Germany, where he played for 16 years. In this league, sports agents are rare. He's signing his contract on his own on the bus ride down to Belton. He'll be in uniform for the Brahmas in a couple of hours against the Central Texas Stampede.
It never happened to me before, so.
The average salary for a player in this league is about $500 a week during the season. Quite a contrast from the millions that other players are making in the NHL, or the show, as the Brahmas refer to it.
I've seen some unbelievable hockey players never get called up, and then I've seen some other hockey players that, you know, were somewhat suspect that people believed, and they got called up and they did well. I mean, it's just being in the right place at the right time.
To pass the time on long trips, some players sleep, others play games, while yet still others always find a way to stir something up. Waking someone with smelling salts is among the team favorites.
Didn't work.
One road trip, Stefan Larocque and our equipment manager, Steve Bregman, were arguing. A couple of pretty big guys, they were arguing about who was the faster runner. And they were arguing about it for 1.5 hours, and they're both sitting behind me, and I got sick of hearing it. So I ordered the bus driver to pull the bus over. I made him go outside, and I made him run a 50-meter dash.
It gets tiring after a while, but it's a good time to hang out with the guys when you're always on the road. And sometimes it tears the team apart, sometimes it just brings the team a lot closer together.
Upon arriving at the arena, the players get situated and begin to focus on the upcoming game.
Some guys have routines, you know, they'll tape the left pad before the right pad and this and that. I don't really have any more than the playoffs. I keep them for playoffs because I can't keep track.
I think the stick is, especially to goal scorers, is the number one piece of equipment they use for their, you know, that's what they make their money with, scoring goals. So every guy does it differently, the way they curve it, the way they fix it up, the way they tape it. But that's something that, you know, no one touches. Everyone leaves that alone. And it's just to each his own how they do it and fix it up. But that's probably, sticks and skates are probably the number one, two things that the players are really concerned about the most.
Some guys like real sharp edges. Some guys like them relatively dull. Just really depends on the ice surface.
What we need to do tonight, boys, okay, with this team, boys, is we need to be physical. You've seen the last time we played these guys, they didn't like it. We can't give that team any good shooting shot percentages, any good shots from the slot.
Come on, boys, let's give it. 1, 2, 3, yeah. Let's go.
Hope you didn't spend your whole welfare check on that shirt. A whole welfare check on the shirt. Welfare check on shirt and season tickets.
Hit him! Hit him.
tripping! Call the trip! Come on! Boys, we need to get the puck to their net, boys.
Hey, way to work it! Way to go, boy! Way to go! Make him pay! Make him pay!
At the end of the first period, the score is tied at 2, but injuries and cuts are already beginning to take their toll.
Let's clean that up a little bit. More stitches again, huh? On average, we stitch up about 2 guys a game.
In the second period, the Brahmas fall behind by 2 more goals before responding to cut the deficit to 1.
Got it and score!
At the end of the second period, the Brahmas are down by 1 goal, 4-3, and Derek Koops still can't stop the bleeding from his right eye.
The only problem is we're right on that, there's a nerve that runs right on that side of the eye, and you usually don't want to do stitches right on the corner of the eye. That's where a lot of the players get cut.
In the third, the Brahmas take advantage of their power play opportunities and make the Stampede pay.
Go score, it's tied! Over the circle, slap shot and score, Fort Worth!
They hang on to win this one by the final of 6-5.
Hey, go eat another burger! Go eat another burger, eh? You sit here every game, you
Let's go away from the road, this is the way it is. The fans are a little bit wild, probably had a few too many beers. But it's good. I mean, the guys, I love the way my guys came back tonight and the way they played in the third period. It was tremendous hockey. They played with a lot of intensity and heart. It's good.
We love hockey. That's the only reason we're playing, because we love the game, and that's why everybody's still playing, because it's not the money, because we don't make no money.